rumah pagi Syahi kom 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 kom.
Bereskan pasangan chat, bereskan pasangan chat, bereskan pasangan chat.
Guys, I'm back again with another episode. I'm Pebble O. This is Pebble Opinion. Welcome. So today, for the first time ever, I'm going to be doing a hip-hop fanfic. So a fanfic is a fanfiction. It's a story you come up with for like famous people. Your characters are obviously famous people. And it's fictional. It's not real. It didn't happen. It's not true. It's fictional. Okay, so whatever I'm about to do here did not happen in real life and hopefully will never happen in real life. So yeah, man, it's just for fun. It's a fan fiction, and this is SA Hip Hop fan fiction. And if you're a fan of SA Hip Hop, I hope that you're gonna enjoy this episode. And today's short story, is called Akanandaba. Akanandaba, or aka Nandaba, Akanandaba. And let's see who our characters are. Who's playing which character? Okay, so we have Anati. Anati's gonna be playing himself. Everybody's gonna be playing themselves, you know. So I'll explain later on who's gonna be doing what. So this is Anati. And next we have Rouge, who's also a rapper, aka, of course, he needs no introduction. Hello. And then we also have Ricky Rick, Uliki Liki, but to feel the boy. Boity, woo! Yes, we have Boity. We have MT, yes, yes, yes. Casper, Neo Vest, the best, the best, the best, the best. I funny. Hi, money. And then we also have Kapo. So those are the guys that we have that are going to be part of this fan fiction. So yeah, man. So this is inspired by The Hangover. If you've seen the movie The Hangover, where a group of friends go out for their friend's bachelor party, this was inspired by that, but there's a young twist to this one, okay? So we have a couple that's getting married, and the couple is Anati and Rouge. So let's meet our couple. So this is our couple, Anati and Rouge. Okay, before we get into the wedding song, this is Anati and Rouge, and throughout the whole thing I'm gonna be playing music, you know, to go along with the story that I'm telling, you know. So this is Anati and Rouge. They are the couple that's getting married today, so let's, you know, get into it a bit. That's our couple that's gonna be getting married. So obviously, before a wedding, there's what? A bachelor party. So the wedding is in Joburg, you know, and the guys decided, you know what, let's throw a bachelor party for our guys. So the bachelor party is gonna be attended by Anati, of course, the groom, as well as his friend, aka and Rick Rick, as well as Kapo. Now, Kapo in this story is Anati's friend from back in the day, you know. They used to be friends. There was a time they went to school together in Pretoria, like for a year, you know. So they were tight before Kapo and Casper became as tight as they were. So that's why Kapo is at the wedding, but Casper's not invited because Casper and Anati are not like quite close, and of course because of the beef that's between, you know, AKA and Casper. So Anati didn't invite Casper to the wedding, his wedding with Rouge, okay? So the guys at the bachelor party, let's meet them. Let's see what's happening at the bachelor party, guys. All right, all right, all right. Hey, hey.
Thank you.
So these were some of the pictures that were taken at the bachelor party. It was going down, as you can see, you know, AKA and Rick having a great time. You know, everybody's there, you know, it's the bachelor party, you know. So yeah. So now, as they are chilling at their bachelor party, they're wondering how Khanti, where is Kapo? Because he was supposed to be at the bachelor party, you know. It was supposed to be AKA Ricky Rick, Kapo, as well as, of course, the groom at the bachelor party. So now they're wondering how. Where is Kapo? Because he was supposed to be here, you know. So then let's find out where Kapo went to. Hey, Kapo. Kapo. Huh. Kapo went to see MC. If you trip and leave the picture alone. So Kapo went to see MT before they went to the bachelor, before going to the bachelor party. He went to see MT because he knows that MT is the link up for some weed, you know. So he thought the party wouldn't be the same without some weed. So he called MT because he's the trusted guy. He's the plug, you know. Like he said, he even has a song called Plug. So Kapo got in touch with MT and they're like, okay, let's link up and then I'll hook you up with some weed. Mm-hmm. So yeah, that's what happened. Kapo wanted to start rolling up the jets with his friends. So he thought, guys, he thought it would be a surprise. He didn't tell them that he was going to get drugs from MT, but he went and then he gave them the weed and then they smoked and they had a great time at the party. And this is what happened the morning after. You remember that the wedding is on this day because the bachelor party happens the day before the wedding. So this happened on Friday and then it's Saturday morning, the morning of the wedding day. So let's check out what happened the next morning. So yeah, this is how the guys were feeling the next morning. They had a lot of drinks, they had a lot of fun, and they also smoked some of Kapo's weed, which he got from MT, remember? So they were just feeling nar in the morning. They were sick, hungover, stama everywhere. Nobody was feeling alright. They were vomiting. And as they busy doing this, they noticed that how Mara someone. Oh yeah. Oh, 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 oh. So now, as the guys are busy like waking up at the hotel, they're like, okay, now it's Kapo as well as Ricky Rick and AKA, right? So now they're getting ready to go back to Joburg, where to the wedding venue, you know, because obviously the wife and the family and the guests must be starting to arrive, you know, and everything. So cool, now they're wondering how, where's Anati? They're like, what? Where's Anati? They look around, they're like, ha, Anati's not around, you know. So now they start asking themselves questions like, what the hell is happening? You know, they look around for him, but he's nowhere to be found. And he's the groom. So what they decide to do is they go to, they report him missing, you know. And I finally is playing a cop. So he's an investigative officer. So they went to the police station and they met with him. And yeah, man, so let's meet, you know, Sergeant Haimani. You know, this is Ifani Haimani, so let's meet the guy. Hey. You know, for a police officer, he's quiet, you know. His fashion sense, yay. Hey. The investigative officer, Mr. Haimani, and then Haimani's like, how, yeah, so when last did you see him? They told him, we went to the party, we drank, we smoked. He's like, did you smoke anything else that you shouldn't have smoked? Maybe. They're like, no, but they feel, you know, extra sick and extra hungover. They're not sure why. And this whole time Kapo is just like quiet, you know. But they know that Kapo did tell them that he went to get some weed from And he, when he came back, he's like, no, guys, I went to get some weed, so let's smoke some weed. So they smoked the weed, they had alcohol, they had their fun, but now this guy's missing. So this guy's like, you know what, because the wedding is today and we don't have time, Mr. Hyman, investigative officer Hyman, he tells the guys, let's do this. Let me refer you to this lady that I work closely with. Her name is Boiti. Boiti is a traditional healer. She's a sangoma. You know, she'll be able to find him quick, fast, in a hurry. So she links them up with, of course, the one, the only, Boiti. And she does her thing like, hey, Medusa. Hoping that that Rosie is gonna vuma, and then of course she did her thing, Medusa by the floor. She's like, you know what, she tells Anati aka and Ricky Rick, because I finally obviously didn't go with him, he just told them where the place is. So he tells the guys, one of you guys here know exactly what happened to Anati, but you're not saying anything. So the guys are just like, what do you mean one of us knows, you know what happened? Now they're looking around, and then Brady points at a couple. He's like, tell your friends where Anati is. Now aka is pissed, everybody's pissed. He's like, wait, he's like, he knows where Anati is, rather not Casper, where Anati is, the groom. Now, AKA is pissed on some, hey, tell us when a couple where Anati is, you know, lyric. And then they're like, no, couple is like, no, he's in Mafikeng. What's he doing in Mafikeng? You know, it's like somebody captured him and yeah. I had something to do with it. So now they have to go to Mafikeng because the wedding, it's an evening wedding. It's starting at 6, you know. Now it's around 10 in the morning. They have to leave Joburg and drive to Mafikeng. That's like 3.5 hours, you know. So now the guys go to Mafikeng to meet this guy who has a problem and who took Anati. They're like, why would anybody want to kidnap Anati at this time? What's the motive? Like, what is happening? And now this one doesn't want to talk, you know. So AKA what he did was he put this one in the boot. As they were traveling to Mafikeng, Kapo was in the boot the whole time, you know, because AKA was that pissed, you know. You know AKA, drama and everything. Ricky Rick tried to reason and everything, but AKA is just like, nah, this nigga is full of shit. So he was in the boot the whole time, the whole drive to Mafikeng. This was AKA the whole time. So yeah, that was Kapo the whole way from Joburg to Mafikeng pleading with AKA to please bula but AKA was not having this, like, when I was dry, like, we are here having a great time and you are busy just like giving us things that we're not even supposed to have. So they asked Anati on some, Kapo, for like what happened there with the weed, and then he told them actually MT gave him nyaope and not just straight weed. It was nyaope, and that's why it got them the way it got them. So AKA is just like, what? So now we're hanging out, but not even weed. Now he's just pissed. And on their way there, guess who's calling? The bride, Rouge, is calling Ricky Rick on some, Ricky, where is my man? Because the wedding is about to start in a few hours and I don't see you guys anywhere here. So where is my man? And she obviously was not happy because they were supposed to be back the previous night, actually, and they decided to stay over. So she was pissed on some, where's my man? Like, she's even see the look on her face. She's just like not understanding, like, where the hell are you guys? Because I don't see you here, and you're supposed to be here with my groom. So, okay, cool. The guys don't tell her that they're going to Mafikeng. Ricky Rick is just like, no, we're gonna come back. There's been a delay. What? He doesn't tell the bride that Anati is actually missing and he's been kidnapped, and now they're off to Mafikeng to try and rescue him. So now the guys get to Mafikeng, and let's see who has been capturing this guy. Who captured Anati? Let's meet the guy. Casper, in your best. Come on. So yeah, man. So this is they got to Mafikeng and they went to the warehouse where they've been keeping, where Casper was keeping Anati, because Capo knew everything, you know. When they got to Mafikeng, Rick tried to talk to Capo and some Capo, what's happening? So Capo told them, no, Casper and I planned this whole thing from the start. I was supposed to go to the bachelor party and then drug you guys so that while we drunk and drug and whatever and out of our minds, Casper can come in and take away, gonna come on this guy, Anati. And they're like, why? It's because Casper actually has a thing for Rouge. You know, he doesn't want Anati and Rouge to get married because he has a serious thing for Rouge and he's hoping that they won't get married so that he can make a move on Rouge. How? Now they're like, what is happening? So as they busy saying this and they celebrating with some, yeah, so we got them and whatever and whatever, AK is just like, I have something to tell you guys. I have a confession to make, says AKA. So he's like, I have a confession to make. Rouge and I, actually, the bride. He's saying this to Casper, Ricky Rick, and Capo. He's like, Rouge and I, actually, have been together and she's expecting my baby, but she was gonna make it look like it's Anati's baby, you know? So, AKA saying this not to spite Anati, but to spite Casper, who now thinks he has a chance with Rouge. So now there's three people interested in Rouge. It's the groom, of course. And then it's Casper, who has now kidnapped the groom. And now AKA, surprisingly out of nowhere, has a confession. So yeah, man, this is my confession. It wasn't my intention, but this ain't my first time. I guess I'll never learn my lesson, but I guess I deserve it. Look at this. This is a picture of AKA and, you know, AKA and Rouge. So they've been together. So AKA was telling them, you know, we've been chilling together. You know, we even have a song together and everything. So we've been, you know, doing this thing under carpet, you know. And now all the guys are shocked. They're like, what? They didn't even see it coming. And this time AKA is having the... Too far from perfect. I'm way deep in my zone and I don't ever think I'll... I bet you don't call me. Call me an asshole. Yes, AKA, you are an asshole. That's why they should call you an asshole. So he's busy going on telling everybody, like, you know what? When Casper release Anati, because even if you don't, Rouge is carrying my child. And I wasn't willing to say anything because I like Anati. But now that you are in the picture, I'm telling everyone because I need to spite you. Anati is just there, you know, heart attacking and everything. Just like, what is happening? Meantime, Rick is trying to keep the peace between Casper and AKA on some, guys, please relax, please wait. And then AKA is just like, if you listen to the words of the song that we made together, Rouge and I, one by one, you will understand that me and this girl have been like this from the very beginning. So here's the song by AKA and Rouge that they made together when they were together. Now you go break my heart in pieces. Mona Lisa, perfect picture. Got me deep like Caesar. I don't wanna buy no Gucci bag for forgiveness. I get R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Best friend, my best friend. I'm not gonna let you get. Baby, give me one more chance. Back, back. What you gonna do? Big boy, I'ma come for you. Fall in love with you all over again. One by one. I hope you heard the lyrics there, AKA talking about I'll never break your heart again, falling in love with you again, and on the hook, of course, Rouge is on some one by one, maybe we can do it two by two. We can do it! So these two have been Vela under carpeting. Hey guys, it's been going down. One by one, take it two by two, what we talking about, me and you, baby, let's go, we can do it, so good, I'm a bad, we're gonna run along, my God. Hey, so it's been going down. So that's the song that they made together. While listening to all of this, Casper was so pissed. He was ready to go to jail. As you can see even here, like that, he's just like, you know what, I wanna kill this guy called AKA because he's just messing with me from all different levels. So he was just pissed, Casper, like, what? I just want to what I me man no smiling. Popping on ya. like pissed and boiling and wanting to kill AKA. Now he's no longer wanting to kill Ananti because he can see that this Ananti guy is actually just useless. The main villain here is AKA that I must deal with, because now he also wants the girl that I want. Like, what the hell? He's even impregnated her. What is happening? And then this whole time, Rikiriki is trying to calm Casper down, because you remember they used to be friends. So these are like pictures from when they used to be friends and cool like that. He's trying to calm him down on some beg. Casper is like, I want to kill this nigga. Okay, now we post on But Casper was not saying it. He's like, I want to introduce you to your maker. Meanwhile, AK is just like, ha, well, I'm having the last laugh because I know she loves me and she's going to be pissed that I exposed her because she wants to get married. But at the end of the day, when I Casper, you will not have her, you know. AK is just like, if I can't have her, you, Casper, will not have her, which is why Ananti can have her. But how's Ananti gonna have Rouge when Rouge is now carrying AKA's child? You know what I'm saying? So AKA just like, whatever, niggas. Congratulate me. He's like, you know what? When I Casper, you don't scare me. In fact, congratulate me, niggas. Nobody gonna shake my confidence. I look you straight up and down. Yeah, now congratulations, baby. Now congratulations, baby. Now congratulations, baby. Now congratulations, baby. And that's how we come to the end of that first episode of SA Hip Hop Fan Fiction. It was, of course, inspired by The Hangover. Like I said, it's a story about guys going out for a bachelor party, only to find out that the groom gets kidnapped, and then one of the groomsmen, aka, actually has impregnated the bride, but he's been keeping it a secret because he actually likes the groom, you know. But, you know, he was just keeping it under wraps. And then the groom gets kidnapped on the night of the bachelor party. One of the, you know, groomsmen organized the whole thing, gave the guys nyaupe. Of course, there was Kapo who got the nyaupe from MT. And then the guys went to go see the police officer, who then told them to go see a Sangoma Boiti. Boiti told them Kapo knows the truth. They go to Mafikeng after Kapo told them that's where Ananti is. And then, hey, all hell breaks loose. But anyway, that's how now the beef between AKA is just like intensifying. But anyway, guys, I hope that you enjoyed that. And yeah, man, I'm Pebble O. This is Pebble Opinion. I'll see you next time.